to talk today about Africa. Now, I'm using Africa specifically because of the tedious easy border wars that have been going on throughout the past many years. Now, in giving this new economy revolution to persons of a country that has been specific in this habit of purchasing guns and weapons, to have little civil wars here or there, to fight over boundaries and battles, in beyond a place that man ever should have gone. I am not in practice. I'm not in the practice to give and supply the monies to these people directly and say, here it is, here's 20,000 and you have it, everyone. And so you're an equalization with the others. You're an equalization with countries that have not partaken in such despicable acts. So I'm not saying to stop, that you're not included, though. I have to include you, because this is part of the reason why you have not gone further. It's part of the reasons you have stayed in such a terrible. So when you have the money supplied, you have the 20,000, it has to be bank limited then. And so there has to be a specific for your business, because you have the money there, your 3,000 that you're going to put toward the business, instead of giving it to your nearest closest army fascist business, it will be going to a bank in that country, a bank that is an international bank, one that is not affiliated, one that is not affiliated with anything local. So you'll be going to that bank, and there you put your 3,000 there, and so then you can work at your bricolages, or you can work at your clothes store. That 3,000 will go into their account for those stores, those work supply houses, for that business. So that'll be, only then can that large amount come off of the guard. It would be taken as a restriction, pool only allowed through this one bank that is in coordinates with us here as a central bank in France. So, now the smaller amounts, yes, you're limited, very limited, because you're gun ready and happy to purchase too many. The smaller amounts of the 30, there's the limit of the 30 a day anyway. So there is like the 10,000 you start, there's a 10,000 that you can never have at the beginning of January all the way through to the end of the year. It's, you just get 30 that you're allowed out for sure in certain off of that tally. And then this other 10,000, the other 10,000 amount is towards your food and your housing. Food and housing. So now to keep it, and then so there is already the large, I want to buy a car, so here's the man there in this one place where, my gosh, perhaps they want to change their ways now. They don't want the frictions, they don't want to fight with that country anymore, because perhaps they have much more money, or they have very, very vengeful traits from the past that they in frictions. Perhaps they don't want to support this army any longer. Well, they same deal. A car heavy purchase, any heavy purchase over, I'm going to say 300. I was going to put the 300 limits on these particular countries of the world. So now, I hope that stops it. It'll bring the discussion in if it's enough. To stop, the group of dudes acquiring so many weapons that they go and play vengeful war tactics against another bordering region. And often these are revenges. I'm looking at many of these fights down there is revenge, one revenge to another. So that should help it put a limit. The limit. And then also, I need to talk specifically on the rich, there they are. There is one rich land, one rich region, and they're like, well, I don't want to join. My people have the money. I tax them a certain amount, and this is the way it goes. And we are wealthy. We don't want to join yours, and yet we do not want to be limited. We do not want a limit, do we? We do not want to be limited on trade, on imports, on exports, at all. We want to still be involved in the system, even through your currency. We don't want to be expelled. So I don't want to hinder this particular this one, where, let's say, a beautiful kingdom and lands with opulent wealth. Maybe each one has over 100,000 a year in income. And so this is going on, and they're like, we don't want a 20, that's so stupid. And so they can stay away if they want. They can stay away from its gathering if they don't want to join. However, there will be a VAT. I will not say VAT, but I will say some kind of a sales tax. There will be a sales tax on any goods that are sent out of our region that has decided that we are 20,000 for every person, and is going with this instead of the old way, going with the Vaux currency, pronounced VAZ. There they are. They've decided they have a rich kingdom. They have no reason to change. So in this per capita, they are all rich and they're all wealthy. Well, then they can stay that way. However, they will be taxed on sales of goods out of their region into ours. We will tax them. So any person, any country or any kingdoms and lands out there that decide that they are staying out of the system of the new world government, they are not going to be receiving fair trade at all with us. It will only be the fair trade between France to Spain. There will be no taxes on goods. And if there is the United States, no taxes on goods, France to the United States, no taxes to goods. As they join, right there, gra, basta. Now, staying out of it, there's a tax on goods. So that is going to be the limit. I'm not going to say don't trade with this over-sustainable rich country at all. I'm not saying do not trade with them. However, you may find it, though. You may find that certain ones will just say, no, I'm not wanting them any longer. And so then you may get a backlash from a few that believe in total equalization, that want equalization amongst all persons on the planet, with the bare necessities of life. So the big struggle I'm seeing right here now is I'm looking at Africa and many of these, the Darfur region and all of this, is we have to put limiter on. They can receive their cards, they can receive their money, but it has to be limiter. It has to be the limiter. Because it cannot be a purchaser, a buyer-purchaser for war, causing civil strifes and weapons. It cannot be anything of this. What else? I don't know. I prefer not to make the Vaux currency global, actually. I prefer that to be just tiny one specifically for the kingdom, only, you know, like an inner kingdom cash, you know, only for the inner kingdom. But all of this counterfeiting is just a problem, isn't it? All these counterfeits. Anyway, the civil strifes hopefully will be ended. Civil strifes will hopefully be ended on this mandation of limiters. So put the limiters on the cards, and then So the 30th day, and then you have the means that's the equal. See, this is a point. So now the person's there. Don't have to be so angry. You don't have to take these trips away and go to foreign lands for work that they never really wanted to do anyway in a foreign land. They can now in their own place, their own, they can build and build beautiful, go for the cob construction, go for that particular construction. What do you call it? The mud hut cob construction that is so popular that they are $1 million. They're $1 million homes in Switzerland. So it's not something cheap. It's not something cheap at all. The cob bale, straw bale construction. So go for this type of property, and so you're not having to go through. I need forest. You know, go for something a little more sustainable. And there it is. The one that used to be the funder for the wars, the little mediocrities. Between this civil strife and that civil strife will go away. And then the man who was the big, hey, I've got a gun, everybody join my army, he is going to be, dudes are going to be like, I don't want to join your army any longer, I have the money myself. I do not have to be a pirate. I have my money myself. And so off they go. Off they go to their bank right there, and they support the business, and they say, well, that is way too many tourist trinkets that are looking that way, and I guess we need change, don't we? We prefer better trinkets, because we get the trinkets. We prefer the tourists and the trinkets over carrying the rifles off to a border and fighting. So, yeah, no. So then on to border wars of Palestine and Israel. Oh my goodness, gosh, it seems like I've gone to the future and then back down into the past, and it's like, what? I'm not ready to wake up to it as a real, someone is still a suicide bomber. I don't want to even think that this is existent, and yet it is possible. It is possible they are still going with those stripes in their brain. I'm not even understanding how that is possible. It just seems a mental case. I don't care what side of war you're on. It seems like they're a mental case. So I don't know. Trank gun? Can you get them with a trank gun from a distance or something? It's just terrible. Don't shoot to kill them. Perhaps we can. How are they supplied with there? How are they supplied with those vests and things? How are they supplied with this equipment? Maybe let their eyes beam in supply that they have property, that their house, their home is available as a price to be sold. Let that be unfortunate. Let that be their new thought. And I hate to say commercialism America is the way to go, but it is something that does bring some kind of status to them, and perhaps they have lost their status, you know what I'm saying? Perhaps they've lost their status. Gosh dang it, I can't mix all these border war countries up at one time, but yeah, I mean, gosh dang it, you know, they're gonna be receiving the money, and is that the reason why they're marching on? Is it just religion? You want to go back? Is it just the religion? Or is it money? Will money actually make it go away? You know?